Good evening, my lovely ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and we are back with Jurassic World Evolution and our Safari Park sort of thingamajiggy. Now, one of the first things I want to do, as was suggested in the last video, is just replace this little bit of fence there with that, just so it blends in a little bit more with the surrounding world. Oh, and maybe just over here as well. And maybe over here as well, just to make sure it does blend in a little bit. Look, you can barely see the little lemon. So, in the last... Oh, hello. Oh, Big Al. What are you doing, Big Al? What are you doing? He's spying the car. Oh, God, Big Al is looking rough, to say the least. Is he going for it? I would personally, in your crotch state, Al, I would not go for the Stegosauruses. I'm just saying, I don't think it's a good idea. I know you're considering it. Okay, good boy. So, in the last video, we added Big Al. We added our Stegosauruses, and we added our Diplodocus, who's now been there somewhere. Big Al's going to go start on the Diplodocus. Where is my Diplodocus? I actually think this is pretty cool, that you can't necessarily click on the dinosaur. Like, it's in there somewhere, alright? We have to try to spot it through the tree line. I quite like that. No, stay over here. I want to see this Diplodocus. It's my first goal. There it is. Look at it just merging through the brush. Very cool. Right. So, we're going to work on our fourth enclosure. And what we're going to do is kind of an arid savannah inspired sort of thing, and then we're going to do a swamp, and then we're going to do Hell Creek. Those are our next three. This was one of the more upvoted things. Basically, you know, if you see an idea that you like the look of on when I ask for suggestions on stuff, just upvote that selection, and you know, it's more likely to be chosen. This was definitely one of the more popular options, so this is what we're gonna do. Now, I want the river to not really be part of this, so we're gonna kind of curve along the riverbed like so, and I want it to be, I still want it to be quite a good size exhibit, but it's gonna be more long than it is. Oh, Big Al is, oh no, let's go check it. Big Al might die here. Big Al might actually die. He must be on very low health, 25%. So there goes on 32. Oh, Big Al's running away. Dinosaurs just don't really kill each other. They square up and then they back off. They're cowards, a lot of them. So I want this to be about half the size. So probably about, curve it up there. That's probably about right. Let's do that. And the idea is to build sort of a savannah. Don't know if I have to say it like that, but you do savannah. Hunting ground sort of feel. So with arid dinosaurs and then maybe a couple of dinosaurs that are meant to sort of resemble lions and stuff like that. So mainly quite a large herbivore filled exhibit, all with arid colouring. And then we'll go from there. We'll see what happens. It's going to be cool. So it's going to be very much open spaces, not many trees. We're going to have like a little oasis and stuff like that. There is actually, you can actually make an exhibit look slightly desert-esque. But what you have to do is cover it in this path, like so. I mean, not like this, because it's crazy, but, you know, you cover the whole thing in this, and eventually it looks somewhat dirt sand-esque. It's a massive pain in the butt, and it never really looks that good. Oh, medium, God, stop fighting the stegos. This could be a dead stego. It only takes one more hit. This is it, this is a real battle come to life. Are they going to fight? Oh, yeah, 1%. This is going to be a kill. It's going to be a kill. We have our first dino kill in the new series. Yes, I would run away as well, buddy. I would run away as well. Well done, Medium Terry. Well done. Now, Medium Terry should feast a lot and be absolutely fine and not hunt for a long time. We shall see. So, let's get back to work. First things first, we need some dinosaurs, basically. I really like, we're going to get a Mementosaurus, because I think the Mementosaurus with its crazy tall neck is going to be, I want every dinosaur to kind of resemble an animal within the park. So I think I don't know what colour though. Alpine? I kind of want, no, steppe. You want browns and whites and blacks and that kind of stuff, or greys. Those are the kind of colours we should be aiming for. That said then, maybe the default Mementi is more, yeah, let's go for default. This is going to be my giraffe, basically. So maybe I should have coloured it like a giraffe now that I think about that for more than 2 seconds. But I didn't. And let's go for hatchery capacity a couple more times. We're going to get some... Somebody did suggest quite a lot of this, so I want to find that person. I can't remember your name, so I can't really thank you, but this will do. The Alpine... Is it Alpine? No, the Savannah. Savannah. Parasaurolophus has like a zebra-esque colouring to it. You know, it's black and white and sort of stripy. So we're going to get three of those to wander around in our little Savannah exhibit as well. I need to tree it up. I'm going to have to change the river because I don't really want the trees just kind of doing this. I think it's going to look a little weird. I'm kind of tempted to get rid of the trees and just have like a thin fence. I think they might ruin it. I'm just going to do it and we're going to see what it looks like, but I'm not convinced, if I'm honest. We shall see. I think it's going to ruin any potential. And savannas do sometimes, you have like a long winding river going along it, and although it looks okay from this side. Let's just do it and we'll see what it looks like and we'll go from there. That's a plan. Either way, it's definitely going to be a very thin and long exhibit. No girth here, ladies and gentlemen. No girth at all. Big Alan, medium to... Oh, someone's about to die. There's no way they both survive this. Right? 57, 56. They may well do. They might just both back off. They're going to fight back and forth constantly. Oh, hell no. Big Al's about to die. Big Al's about to die. Medium Terry is going to take it. And emerges the dominant force within our Morris population. Damn, Terry. Damn. Terry loves yogurt. Anyways. So, you're going to drive through? I think it's just too close. I'm going to get rid of the trees on the right. All these trees. I think as a savannah, it needs to feel at least partially like a big, wide, open sort of plain area, you know? And it's not the longest exhibit in the world. Not the biggest exhibit in the world, but that already looks better to me. Even with the fence. What we're going to do as well. The Hell Creek exhibit is going to be massive if I keep it up as it is. So we're going to bring this forward to there instead. And we're going to just curl through the river. We can mess around with the river. The river isn't set in stone. I just want to make this exhibit a little bit bigger. Because, I mean, Hell Creek is massive. It doesn't need to be that big. So all this now is going to be Savannah. All this. Look at that. Beautiful. It's humongous now. Humongous. And we can mess around to make it look a little bit less wet, basically. Fences. I want to replace this with, like, steel. Don't know why I didn't do it in the first place, but the dinosaurs don't break out anyway, so it doesn't really matter, does it? Doesn't really matter. Okay, dokie. Right, let's have a look at that. How big is that? That's much better. Much better. Tons of space to play with, right? Kill the river. We'll bring it back at some point, but for now, I'm just going to kill it. Like so. You are now dead. And I'm thinking the same again, that we might just... It's going to go into a swamp, right? And swamps shouldn't necessarily be big and foresty. They should be... I mean, they should be foresty, but not super... Like, it's too foresty, is the point I'm trying to make here. It's too... It's suspiciously foresty, you know? Right, okay. Anyways, let's get our momentum, yeah? Actually, oh no, so parasols, okay. The Memeji had the plus speed, and it's taking bloody ages, and the Parasaurus didn't, and they're, you know, popping out in no time. This my zebra, and it does, doesn't it? It kind of, it's stripy, it's black and white, it's got a little bit of blue to it, but it's a zebra, basically. Now, how many do we need? Only four. Has that been changed? Weird. We'll get another one. And these guys can just hang around here for a little bit. Do they have food? They do not have food. Now they have food. Okay, let's back to work. Right, so, I like the idea. Clicking the right button. The first idea I like is clicking the correct, well, let's just kill all this, because it's distracting me. And that tree, and this blimmin' weird old... Flatten. God, I want a bigger flatten tool. Oh, it's so small. Okay, there we go. The riff has kind of messed it up, so I kind of need to flatten the entire... What is this, by the way? What is this over here? This needs changing. This is silly. Okay, that's better. We can work from there. I just want it to look pretty. I'm not asking for much. It's a little bobbly, but it's less bobbly. Okay, nice big open exhibit. A little bit of a forest on the left. You know, there's forests in that kind of area. But mainly I want this to be sort of wide open areas. And we're going to make a little oasis, maybe over here. And then we'll have all the trees kind of like stacked up around it. Like an oasis. Maybe a couple kind of more. I might even kill some of these side ones, you know. I really do want it to feel... I want the oasis to feel special with its trees, you know. And if there's trees absolutely bloody everywhere, then the oasis is less important. So even if you can see the fence, which is a little bit of a shame, we have to make sacrifices. Let's just replace all this fence with better fence. Slash worse fence, depending on your prerogative. Kill the fence, kill the fence. Kill the fence for what it did to my family. Yeah, it definitely has more of that kind of savannah feeling. Little oasis, maybe a... Now, I do want the river to still exist, but I'm... Oh, hello, Cheeky. What are you doing? Don't do that. So the river, I mean, it's not going to stop dead here. The river should carry on. So let's just build it for now. I do want it to kind of maybe curl around the outside like that, because it's going to turn into a swamp, right? But what we're going to do, maybe it's a little thicker here, but then it should... thin out massively. It should be a really skinny, weedy little river. Because it's a dry environment, right? Until it gets into the swamp over here, and then maybe it can expand out a little bit. There we go. And maybe it even goes over here. Meow! Into the... that bit. And again, teeny, teeny, tiny. It's teeny tiny. Oh, no, that's too teeny tiny. I think it might be too thick, if anything. There we go. So it's like, yeah, I like that. It might be too wet still, but it's got an oasis. It's got like a thin, winding river. It's got like a big open plain sort of area. It's all white. Right, let's nip over here. That should be my other power sword done. Yep. And my Menchi. Now, the other suggestion, I believe, was the default Stiggy Moloch. Because the default Stiggy Moloch has like a brownish, potentially gazelle-esque colouring to it, I guess you'd say. I don't know what we're going to do for the lion. I think we're going to do a Majungasaurus for the lion. A lot of people suggested the Majungasaurus unrelated to this idea. And I really like the Majungasaurus, so I don't want to neglect it, basically. Let's get these little dudes shot in the face. No problem. Adding task. They do. They look like a proper... If only they actually herded properly, but they do look like a little zebra dinosaur group. And there's our giraffe. Bam, look at that neck. That is a proper giraffe neck. Love it. Yeah, I should have done a different... We might make another Momenchi, now that I think about it. We might make a brown one. Now that I'm leaning into this whole... savannah kind of look, you know? Come on, get out of the way. Come on! Come on! Come on! Momenchi face. Momenchi face. Right, so what do we have any... I mean, step could definitely be the right. I'm gonna make a step one. We're gonna keep the other one around just in case. I'm just gonna let it live its life for a little bit, and then we'll see what happens. So let's go back to work while we're waiting for that to happen. So yeah, we're gonna do the swamp here, and then big Hell Creek, big Hell Creek exhibit right here. It's gonna be cool. We need we've got a gate there already. The other gate's gonna be down here somewhere. Kind of moved away from the no fences thing, but I just think it was necessary. I think it's still going to be, even if you see the fences, I think it's going to be really cool to drive through. And even though this is grass, it does, to me, look a little bit like a kind of savannah kind of thing, you know? I really want that to feel like a secret oasis. I'm struggling. I have to not mess with this too much. I have to try to not, you know, put in loads of hills and stuff like that. I really do want to make this rivers. I don't think I can make it any smaller. A little bit. I just want it as thin and weedy as possible, you know? Oh, see, that's what I'm trying to avoid, that. There we go. Well, you can just see how the grass and the land beneath it comes up a little bit because it's so thin. Like there, you can see it's very shallow water. Water, darling. Taking a risk. And on this bit here, it kind of goes along, but then it got so dry and so thin that the water couldn't sustain itself into a flow, so it's just got these kind of stagnant little puddles now. That's the idea, anyway. I don't really want to mess with it. I don't think, as a savannah sort of area, I don't think it should have hills and stuff. It should be a flat plain. And it's very hard for me to leave it alone, but I'm going to try. We're going to add some shrubs in the area around. I mean, this is the most... the wateriest part of the whole thing, right? So that should have most of the life. The shrubs are weird. From above, I think they look really bad. That looks weird. But when you get down to ground level, you know, they look pretty good. You know, that looks fine. I'm down with that. It's just a very... I love that, because you're like, you're over here, right? And it's kind of dead. There's really nothing much here, which is obviously on purpose. Maybe we can have one tree. If I can make a single tree, I'll make a single tree. Oh, beautiful. So we got one tree, but it's a fairly dead area. Unless you get over here, like you're looking over there, it's just nothing to it. And you get over here, and it just feels like you're entering this whole other little world. And that's how it should feel. It should feel, you know, it's an oasis in the desert. It should feel like that. Beautiful. Okie dokie. So, shabow. Let's get our stiggies on the go. Get these parasaurs shifted over as well. Let's not crazy, we need 6 parasaurs. Oh no, it's 4. We just checked this a second ago. How many stiggies is it? I think it's 4. There's need one more sticky. Come on. Out of your pop, lad. Out of your bloody pop. Blast, I guess. Sticky. We're also gonna have to get more stegosauruses, which is partly what I was worried about, admittedly, but hey ho. Oh my god, Medium Terry is about to die. Oh! Ow! Damn, son! Terry's killer. Oof. Jesus! Do not get on the wrong side of a Stegosaurus. Right. So we need another Stegosaurus and we need another Allosaurus. We need 2 more Allosauruses, actually. Medium Terry just got his ass whooped. These are quite, yeah, they're nice. They're like smaller, brown sort of creatures you can imagine living in a savannah kind of environment. That Memenchi's awesome, it really is. It's just not the right colouring. It's just very grey. I'm looking for more like a sandy brown sort of thing. Stinkies are great though. Apparently the headbutt animation, at least for the Pachycephalosaurus, I don't know about the Stiggy and the Triporex, is in the game when your dinosaurs are at their max social thing. I've literally never, ever seen it, but when it comes to Hell Creek, we're going to max out our Pachycephalosaurus population, unless it's something crazy like 18, and we'll see if we can make it happen. I mean, for example, what's your maximum population? Yes, it's 12, 12 just feels like too many. That's a cool looking dinosaur. I'll just grab that, because that's adorable right there. Absolutely adorable. Look how cute that thing is. Seriously, it's crazy. It's actually super, 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 super cute. Little depth of field there. Which again, I don't think you guys can see, but it's good for the thumbnail. Beautiful. Bam. Aww. Look at it. It's actually little tongue. Blam. What are you doing? It's little hench fists as well, you know. It's proper, like, it's adorable, but it'll punch you in the jaw. It's kind of my thing. There we go, that's all our stickies. Wait, how many stickies is that? Is that 4? I don't want 4, because we've got 4 parasaurs. I'm going to have 6. You should have, like, one of your biggest creature, like a medium number of your medium creatures, maybe 2 carnivores, and lots of your smallest creature. That's how you should balance things, in my opinion. Asset delivery confirmed. So I'm going to have 6 stickies, all the same color. No, I'm going to get one wand at cancel. I'm going to get one that's a different colour, and it's going to be the leader of the Stiggies, okay? So which Stiggy? There's one that I really like. We're going to go for Arid, just because it's a Savannah, basically. So the Arid Stiggy shall be the leader of the Stiggies. Oh, we need food. Herb dope. Alright, where would you put food here? I want to hide it, but I also don't want to kill all my trees. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that'll do. It's nice that they'll, you know, the dinosaurs. Like, sometimes you'll drive in here and you just won't see anything. You'll see the oasis and you'll get a glimpse of the dinosaurs within it, but generally speaking, you just won't see much. I thought it's so hard for me not to add stuff here. It really is. It's really a struggle. Maybe the river could split off again and come down here a little bit, just so there's something. I just need something, you know? It's so thick by default. Although that is the biggest brush, it's kind of my bad. No. Stop using the biggest brush, you nerd. It's totally my fault, but whatever, shush. Oh my god, stop it! I keep telling myself not to do it and then I keep doing it. There, small. It doesn't really matter in reality, but still. I just need something. I just need something. There we go. Maybe a tree around here. Just a little bit. Just a little. You know, this is where the river ends. The trees build around there a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay, and now I'm going to leave it alone. It has to remain an open plain. It has to. We can put in some some shrubbery, right? Like maybe over here. Because you would have shrubs. There we go. That's it. But generally speaking, you're not going to see the dinosaurs that often. You're going to like get a glimpse of them in the distance, but in the shadows of the oasis, and they're going to hang out and probably drink the oasis water more than anything else. So you have to drive up really close to get hold of them, which is cool, I think. Bow. Arid. All right, that's my last two. Did I not shoot the others? I did not shoot the others.
Acknowledged.
Acknowledged.
Task received.
And that's my Memenchi done as well. Right, so all we need... Oh, Majungasaurus, never mind. I was going to say, well, we need to do this decide on a carnivore. But we don't need to decide on a carnivore because we're using Majungasaurus. I can't remember patterning... I think the Alpine's the one we want... No. The jungle one is like crimson red. The rainforest one is like a pale blue. Why this doesn't update the image on the bottom right, I don't know. I can't remember what step looks like. I can't remember what tundra and alpine look like. There's only one solution for this. Step is my main choice, I think. So we're going to make a lot of them. That's the goal right now. We're going to make a few of them. And we'll see which one's the best colour. Because tundra, okay, it's tundra. But it could be the right colour. Because, you know, tundra is quite white and dark and blah, blah, blah. Which might suit the savannah kind of feel. I suspect step is the one that we want to use. But there's no way to check, really. Because I suspect that, and I do want two of them, I'm going to make two step ones. And then we'll make a alpine one once the Memenchi's gone. That's the plan. Take your time, love. Except Memenchi, what are you doing? Except going absolutely blimmin' mental. Oh, that's the wrong. Ah, see, look how much better that... That's a giraffe right there. I love it. Yeah, that's way better cloning. This Memenchi is just going to live here, do its thing. Slowly go suicidal by the looks of it. Yeah, it's fine. It's what it is. Love you. Love you so much. Memenchi might be my second favourite sauropod. Brachiosaurus is always going to be the top just because it has that nostalgia inherently part of it. But the Memenchi's, oh, I love that neck. Some people get really annoyed about the Memenchi because it doesn't look that much like the one from the Lost World Jurassic Park, but the one in the Lost World Jurassic Park looks absolutely goddamn terrible, so I don't really mind them making a couple of changes, if I'm honest.
Setting additional tasks.
So many sticky Molochs. That sounds short, but there it is. Let's get them shifted over. Honestly, this is what I spend half my time doing. You are the slowest helicopter pilot in the world. Seriously, what is taking you so long, son? Two down, four to go, and a Memenchi.
Heading to collect the asset.
Oh, okay. See, I had a go at him, and now he's picking his pace up a little bit. Shouting at people is a very effective, usable tactic. You're getting shot. Where's my other Momenti? That's the wrong one. Giraffe. Where's my giraffe gone? I feel like I'm missing a sticky somewhere. Oh yeah, I'm right there. Cheeky little so-and-so hiding in there. That's everything I need to get shot there. And we needed one more with Jungasaurus, didn't we? Alpine. And we'll just see, basically. If I hatch the step one first and it's perfect, then we can cancel the others as well. And I don't know what the maximum social group for the Majunga is. I imagine it's two. It seems to be for most carnivores that aren't raptors, Deinonychuses, or Dilophosauruses, other than the Ceratosaurus, which was two for a long time, and it's now three. Ceratosaurus would have been a good shout, actually, because it's got the alpine pattern that looks really cool. Not alpine, it's arid? I don't know. Coastal looks pretty cool as well. Anyways, collecting asset. Okay, that's Stigmol at number six, and on Momenti, I think that's everybody now moving across. Everybody's been shot in the face, more importantly than anything else. Everyone's been shot. So we're going to have four parasaurs, six stiggies, one Momenti, and two Majungas. So it's our first exhibit with four different types of dinosaur. I also need to get a Stegosaurus and an Allosaurus, but we'll come to that in a little bit. I can't feel bad for this Momentisaurus. I'm going to sell it, just because I feel really mean. Is it going to live here alone? Uncomfortable, slowly dying of unhappiness. Loneliness. It's kind of sad. Our swamp exhibit is going to be a disaster, by the way. Because I want a Spinosaurus, a Suchomimus, and a Baryonyx, all of them in it, and they're just going to murder each other. They're going to absolutely slaughter each other. But what we can do is actually attach it maybe just a little bit to this bit over here, right? And we can put a gate here and release them in. That's not a bad idea. That way, at least we can keep a constant supply of large carnivores ready. We're going to put some Dilos, because I think a Dilophosaurus is a perfect dinosaur for a swamp. It's got that kind of poisonous, blah, kind of look to it. You know what I mean? Blah! You guys get me. Although the Deinonychus is pretty perfect as well. Because it looks like a tadpole, basically. What else? Dilophosaurus, those three. And then I do want a herbivore in there, I guess. Maybe like a little one that survives just by hiding. Or maybe like more like an ankylosaurid sort of one that survives by, you know, just being a badass. No sauropods. We're going to hold back on the sauropods because there's always been a bloody sauropod. Anyways, Majunga step. This is one we want to see. What does it look like? Are we in business? I just want like a... It's okay. What do you look like? You better? Yeah, you're better. I'm gonna go for you. What are you? Alright, calm down, buddy. Tundra. Tundra is browner than steppe. It makes no sense whatsoever. Let's get all these shot. So, we need another Tundra one. Tundra's looking pretty good. It's brown, it's stripy. Everything I want and I love her. Right, let's just check quickly as well. What is your social grouping? Yes, I thought it was. It'd be nice if they mixed that up a little bit more. All the big carnivores, other than the Ceratosaurus, are one or two. There's really no exception. Ceratosaurus is three. That's the only one. Be nice. Allosaurus should not be a single social group, for example. I know we've talked about this before, but... Is that different? Oh, it's a different colour when it's selling. That's a cool little detail. Chuka, 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 chuka. And so forth, in a chugri matter. I'm looking up at it. Hey, Pachubes. He just sees this dinner floating above him. He's genuinely looking up and he's interested in it. Which is pretty cool. He's about to get shot in the face. So why am I shooting you in the face? Alpine, don't need you. We'll see what the Alpine... They've added a cancel option for mid-incubation, but not one for when it's finished. Which I guess is fine, because you just release it and sell it. But that'd be a good option as well. Just a little X here, you know, I don't want to release it, I want to kill it. Anyways, before the Majungas arrive and kill everything, basically, we're going to do our little tour now, and then next episode we'll fly in the Majungas, like we tend to do. We tend to move in the carnivores pretty late. Is everything else over there now? Right, they're getting, by the time we get there, those two dinosaurs will be shipped in, so let's go on a little journey. Ranger Station 2, I believe. Yes. No. They move every time. Not two anymore. Let's go! Bomb. Enclosure number one. Actually, still might be my favourite. I think it looks really cool. Delivery complete. I don't want to, like, every time I go through, I want to stop and take pictures. Need to get out of the habit, I think. Yeah, I really like this one. Something very natural feeling about it, just because it's the bumpy land, you know, the bumpy land and the way the water's formed and the sparse trees and whee! It just feels like a really, like herbivores would love to live in this place, you know, this is where they would gather in reality. Bump. Same with this one, a little bit heavier on the trees, this one, but then you turn to the left and it proper opens up. None of the dinosaurs really hang out around here, because why would they? But then we break back through the trees. We see our Kentros, Camarasauruses hanging out together. Beautiful. Deinonychus, rarely spotted, but every now and again emerges out to drink. Onwards! Now, this exhibit is much safer than it was yesterday. There's currently no Allosauruses. Well, there's actually two, but they're both dead. So we can't go anywhere to the right. We're going to curve up to the left. Drive up the only path, up the mountain. Use that as a way to survey the exhibit below. There's a stego there, bounding around. Should be the Diplodocus somewhere. Really, at the moment, it's just a bunch of Stegosauruses. Not even that many Stegosauruses, because one of them's dead as well. Oh, there's my little ditch. I forgot about the ditch. Beautiful. Moving on. The new exhibit. Savannah. Bump. Even if you can see the fence, I think it's still got that Savannah kind of look to it, you know? I think that'll look better as well. When, maybe what we can do is just put trees on the other side for the Hill Creek exhibit. That way this area still feels quite big and open, but I like that though. A little Mount Sebo in the background as well. This looks like an open range sort of thing, which is precisely what it should look like. Some oasis over there, but I did spot a little parasaur over here, so we're going to have a little sneaky peek over this way first. There she is. Have you seen anyone else? I can see them in there. I can't. They're not doing much. There's another parasol there in the middle. Alright, let's go check out the oasis. There might be too much water here. I think I'm gonna try to weaken that a little bit. Same with over here. This is a bit thick here. Scare you, love. Ugh. And there's our giraffe. Eating, currently, which is a shame, but still. Didn't I move Sticky Bullocks in it? I've not seen a single stick. Where are my stickies? That's the question right now. I can hear them. Wah! The terrifying Sticky Bullock noise, but I can't see a single one. That's our only goal right now on our safari. Find. Oh, right there, under the giraffe. Hello. Proper staring me down, isn't he? Alright, buddy, I'm sorry. Well, there's one, but there's six. God, look at the size of this thing. It's very cool. I love that when you zoom in on something and it's just massive, it fills your frame and you have to move your camera up and zoom out. So. Where are the other stickies? One, two, three. Oh, there's three of them right here, actually. What I might do is try to hide a feeder. Over here as well, by the river, just some more dinosaurs. I mean, this Oh, there's a Stiggy there, and there's a parasaur in the distance. Oh, hello. Oh, there's our captain one. I forgot about that one. Come on, not you, you nerd. This one. See, some of them have gone over here, actually. There's a lot of Stiggies in this side. There's another one over there. Oh, hello. That one really fits as well. That's a very cool colouring. This is the leader Stiggy. Captain of the Stiggy Molochs. Which is the dream, quite frankly, I think we'll all admit. Beautiful. Beautiful. I want to grow to love the parasaurs. I just... For some reason, it just doesn't do it for me. What is it about the parasaur that doesn't work for me? I don't know. I really don't. I just don't know what it is. I really don't. If anyone knows why I really like the JPOG Parasaur Office, but not the Jurassic World Evolution one, please let me know, because I can't figure it out. Whatever. Right, we're going to end it there, folks. Next episode, we'll bring in our Majungasauruses and start working on our swamp exhibit as well. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for all the suggestions and stuff. If you have any ideas about the swamp, how we should put it together, feel free to leave those down below as well. And I'll see you lovely folks then. Cheers. Oh, I think I might make it a ditch. I like the idea of coming out to Savannah, right? And dropping down a slope instantly. Kind of like a little bit rough and tumble, a little bit like the Jurassic Park the ride where they go down at the end. Oof, hello, love. Poof, so you drop down and then it's like this sunken... Maybe it's like a crater. It's like a sunken crater, right? And all the water naturally goes there. Kind of like the Congo and like Ungoro Crater in World of Warcraft, right? And that becomes like a much more lush area because it's blocked from desert winds and stuff like that, but also because it's lower, that's where all the water collects. I really like this idea. Plus it'll be quite fun to drive through the gate and instantly go like, whee, and sort of go down a massive ramp into like this lush swampy crater sort of thing. That's a very cool idea. We're gonna do that. But if you have any further suggestions, feel free to let me know. I think we're gonna cut it around to about there, and then this is all gonna be Hell Creek. That sounds like a plan. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.